Yes, I pray. Heavy hitter. Man, I got this sold up. Many boys, they know us. All fast money, no slow bucks. No one can control us.
Chilling with my bros, yeah. And you know I got a gang of pre-rolls. Getting high, blazing with the bros, talking about these hoes, yeah. Getting high, chilling with my bros, and you know I got a gang of pre-rolls. Getting high, blazing with the bros, trying to dodge these hoes.
I know that bitches is checking for me. I know that they do whatever for me. I know I look good and I got a nice fright, and I stay in my bag cause I got my own vibe. And I know that they don't get a chance from you. She told me easy, I got plans for you. I know she look good and she got a fat ass, and she just my type. Normally I would smash, but tonight I'm just getting high, chilling with my bros. And you know I got a gang of pre-rolls. Getting high, blazing with the bros, talking about these hoes. Getting high, chilling with my bros, and you know I got a gang of pre-rolls. Getting high, blazing with the bros, trying to dodge these hoes.
The ace is gone. Weed smoke in the air. My face is gone. Petit Philippe. Yeah, my face is on. Can't none of y'all face the dawn. JC on. No mask. Glow in the dark bottles. No glass. Walk past my section. You trespass. Murder the club. Toe tag. Balenciaga's killing niggas. 4-4 mag. The body bag crew. Coming soon to a club near you. Bet your bitch there too. Bet the ass on the ass then drag like Betty Boo. Bet I feel like Hov on the run. You ready, boo? Baptized in Regals. Black cars medieval, black guns illegal, be charges in Fred Siegel, can we celebrate, turn bottles upside down till every chick in our section start to levitate.
Getting high, chilling with my bros, and you know I got a gang of pre-rolls. Getting high, blazing with the bros, talking about these hoes. Getting high, chilling with my bros, and you know I got a gang of pre-rolls. Getting high, blazing with the bros, trying to dodge these hoes.
I'm a giver, giver. Damn right, I'm a giver, giver. Give you every inch of me. Return the favor whenever you please. I'm a giver. Oh, I'm only worried about you. You can finish me later. Oh, clear the table off, lay it down. I'ma be your waiter. Till your body's dehydrated. You didn't think I could go that long. Cause I'm the handyman giving you maintenance. A pleasure to have your acquaintance. I'm about giving you overtime. Stick to the beat like a cadence. Yeah, I'm an oxymoron, you'll see it. Gonna cherish every moment. Receive it. Receive it, cause I'm a giver, giver. Damn right, I'm a giver, giver. Give you every inch of me. Return the favor whenever you please. I'm a giver. I'm a giver. Giver. Damn right, I'm a giver. Giver. Else don't matter. Oh, life 51 shades. I'ma add a new chapter. Till the bedroom is over. Flooded, hold on. The way that your curves are engineered and wrong. My medicine come with a warning. Wake up, hit me in the morning. I'll be there, no time to waste. Make you get hoarse just for moaning. No, you ain't never had it. I'm a giver, giver. Damn right, I'm a giver, giver. Give you every inch of me,
every inch of me.
Turn the favor whenever you please. I'm a giver,
I'ma give you that good thing.
I'm a giver,
yeah.
Giver.
Oh baby,
damn right, I'm a giver,
I'ma give you
giver.
Everything you need.
Gratification is to leave.
Yeah.
I'm a giver.
Yeah.
And, you know, one of the things I've always said, I've owned single family homes and condos over the years. And every single time I did that, when I finally sold, I would just break even.
Yeah.
I never actually made, and some of them I owned for 2 or 3 years, some of them I owned for like 10 or 12 years. But at no time did I make any sort of real profit. It more or less just broke even.
Yeah. And you're worried the whole time because you're dependent upon one door. You know, it goes back to this thing I say, never depend on one of anything, ever. Like you need, for real estate to work, you need a lot of doors. You know, the reason Amazon works is because they got a lot of doors into Amazon.
Well, yeah. I mean, my first house that I bought, it was $500,000 home in the Oakland Hills. You know, I was in the tech business, and right after I bought it, the tech bust happened in 2000. And I had this mortgage, and I had no income coming in, and I had to panic and just sell it as quickly as possible.
Yeah, and people act like everybody makes money on real estate. That's not true. Like, there was millions and millions of people that lost their homes in 2008 and 2009 and 2010. It wasn't a handful of people, dude. It was millions of families across the country. They didn't just lose their house and the profits. They lost their credit. Because they were having to pay for that thing. And that's what I learned. I spent 3 years, Vlad, after I made a mistake on that first deal. And the mistake I made was I should have got in that deal, put a tenant in, and sold the house to somebody else that would collect the rent. But what I did was I held it and didn't understand the whole marketplace. And so I spent the next 3 years in Houston shopping real estate and learning what the big moguls, the word you use, the big real estate moguls did. And what all real estate moguls do, whether it was Sam Zell or Donald Trump's dad, Fred, was they always bought multiple doors and rented them out to typically in one location so that they had big income flows from and not dependent upon one door.
Well, your next real estate purchase, it was a 38-unit complex in San Diego.
Yeah.
Which cost $1.9 million.
This guy knows it all, man.
Well, and you put $350,000 down on this big unit. So how did you have $350,000 in cash at that point?
I was banking cash. So for the next 3 years, I stayed at the same job I had. I actually transferred out of the auto business and started because I got really good in the auto space. People knew about me and kind of what I had done in this little car dealership. I started consulting manufacturers around the United States, and I had a business. That was my company. And I would take all the extra money, and I would just store it off to the side. I didn't understand stocks. I've never understood stocks, as I said, you know. And I didn't want to trade paper for paper. I wanted to be in metal, glass, concrete, something I could touch and hold. So what I did was I studied real estate for 3 years. I bought my first deal after looking at thousands and thousands of properties. My next deal was $1.9 million. I put $350,000 in. And then closed that deal. 30 days later, bought another deal. 90 days after that, bought another deal. Had like 200 units within 4 or 5 months. But it took me 3 years of doing research, looking at deals to get comfortable enough to know the right thing to pull the trigger on.
Okay, so what made that San Diego 38 unit property the right deal at that point?
Well, a number of factors that I still use today. Number one, it was below replacement value. That means somebody couldn't build it for less than I was buying it for. Number two, it cash flowed from the first day that I owned it. Even if it was only 88% occupied, probably even down to 85, maybe even down to 80, it would still cash flow, meaning it would pay for the debt and all the expenses of the property. Three, it was going to provide me with somewhere between 6 and 12% cash flow per year, better than the banks at that time. And four, I believed it was hard to replace that piece of property and that I would sell that in the future for some number above what I paid for it, based on not the property, but based on the income that the property produced. And that was the piece that I was missing when I bought my first deal, right? This kind of real estate, like the houses you talked about, they're only worth is what somebody's willing to pay for that house. The real estate that I buy today is people are buying the income from the real estate. They're not buying. It's what is the value of Netflix? Well, the more subscribers they get, the more valuable people think it is. I'm basically in real estate buying cash flow, not It's a beautiful house in the neighborhood, and it's got a great location. We're buying great locations. Yes, they look good, but most importantly, they provide they create cash flow for the investor.
Okay, and what year was this?
This was I'm 33 years old. Mid-90s maybe?
Mid-90s, okay.
Yeah.
So
this is after the savings and loans bust. This is mid-90s. Right. You couldn't get getting a loan at that time on a place was hard. You had to put a lot of money down, similar to what it is today. And this is good. You don't want to over-leverage debt, okay? When the economy collapsed in 2007, I didn't lose anything. All my buddies lost everything because they over-leveraged. I didn't put a bunch of money down. The banks did not want to give me a loan on the deal. I had to go to three or four banks to get my first loan, first real estate loan. So I financed, I think, on that deal, $1.5 million. Ended up selling that place for almost $6 million. I made more money on my first real estate deal than I made for my business in 5 years. So I was hooked.
Okay, how many years later did you sell that property?
I think I sold that thing 3.5 years later, 36 months.
Wow, so you tripled your money on that property.
No, I 10x'd my money. Oh, I only put $350 down.
Oh, right. Yeah, because you put down $350. Got
it. So I crushed it.
Okay.
I was hooked, dude. I was like, okay, I'm going to get rich doing this. After my first deal, I'm like, I'm not going to get rich. I'm going to get wealthy doing this. You can get rich at work. You know this. You get wealthy investing.
You're about to go to the world of Sirius and the best of the best video DJs that the world has ever seen. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the visual mix master, DJ Yobra 254.
Hold up. Get right with you. I'm going to get right with you.
The Crowd Spinner. They say he's only known to have the best of the best video mixes that anyone can wish to see. Yeah, you fucking haters. We ain't stopping till we see heaven on earth. It's DJ Yobra 254. Playing you tomorrow's hits today.
I just want a rolly with a dapper ranch. I already got some designer to hold on my pants.
I'm a fool. I throw you off. Just a fucking show. I just swing out my door.
Lord King, yeah, you know who it is. It's DJ Yobra 254, the Crowd Spinner. DJ Yobra. Motherfuckers, let me give a shout out to my real fans and professional DJs. Middle finger up to you haters. Ha ha. DJ Yobra 254. Don't fight the urge to let your head bounce to the beat. For event bookings, holler your DJ Yobra 254 on 0706-827-125.
Yeah. Hold up. Get right with you. I'ma get right with you. Hold up, get right with you, I'ma get right with you. Bad bitches fuck up, then dismiss them. I ain't really here to take no pictures. Flash.